I actually have the email. I kept it from 2006 when a buddy emailed me and was like, hey, just FYI, found a new good site for internet videos, youtube.com. Because no one knew about it. It was not a household thing. And so on a whim, I started uploading these videos to YouTube, just thinking that if I'm interested in this, there's got to be so many people that are interested in what, you know, wasn't nearly as big a market then as it is now. And so I bought this benchtop machine. This mill was literally next to the pillow of my twin bed in a one-bedroom apartment in New York. So God bless my wife. And so we moved into what's called a junior four, which in New York City terms is, it's a two-bedroom, but we legally can't call it a two-bedroom because the second bedroom isn't big enough. And that's what I made into the little machine shop. And I had the tag in there, and then I bought a little 7-inch lathe, and I bought a finger brake, a grinder, a drill press. I mean, this was like heaven to me. I started doing sort of work for other people. It was friends, it was family, it was cufflinks for people, or little tchotchkes, some of it I got paid for. A lot of it was just, I was so happy to be able to make something. It was so cool that this was perfect. And it was great because I learned over these first 3 or 4 years, there's no pressure. It was just fun. I had done this research and I was dead set on a Tormach machine. It was just perfect. It's all I wanted. Like, I was like, this thing is a monster machine for me. It'll let me make this stuff that was so slow to make or machine. And so I finally convinced my wife to move out of Manhattan to the suburbs, specifically to get a Tormach machine. I know that sounds crazy, but it was to grow this business and so forth. But all I wanted was a walkout basement so that we could fit an 1100 in the basement or the garage. And that's kind of how that went. Here is a small residential house in New York, and a little factory inside. And the truth is, we made a lot of money. I mean, we made thousands of products on this mill behind me, the exact one. And then I started a new company, and then we started doing the job shop work. And this is all while I'm doing a day job as well. We crushed it, and then you're getting paid to make stuff. I'm very sympathetic to people that were in my shoes 10 years ago, which is trying to get from nothing or an idea to something. So I love that, and I enjoy working that. And I think I still do some of the job shopping is a tough business. I still do a lot of it because I enjoy the satisfaction of working with customers, but also I don't think I really have any insecurities about being a machinist in that sense, but I'm always looking to figure out how to push myself to be better. And I'm always wondering, when am I not gonna be able to do this, because I just don't know enough and I can't figure out. I actually spend a lot of my time doing the YouTube videos. I really enjoy it, and it's just something where I spend a lot of my personal time. Because the YouTube channel also grew in popularity, then that's really our source of traffic for the training classes and the job shop stuff. So then it's cool because it's fun to be some form of a source or leader in what's going on here. And then we just started doing CNC training. So we have these in-person classes where folks can come, and that's actually a big reason why we're moving next door. We'll have a dedicated classroom. We've got two 1100s, two 440 machines, and so it's 2 and 3 day sort of CNC intensive learning classes. Yeah, we're definitely not what you'd think of as a traditional machine shop at all. We never will be, just because I'm certainly younger than your average guy that's running a shop, and certainly have a much, I think, different background, probably a heavier technology background. I think if I had grown up as a machinist, while it's fun to think that would have been awesome, I think I never would have been here. It just would have, and in some respects, it would have, you know, when I first bought that tank, benchtop mill, literally the engineer that we'd hired to help us, great guy, told us, do not buy that. That's a huge mistake. You can't run those things. And he was wrong, but it was a little more taboo then than I think it is now. And I think that's one reason why, you know, joking or corniness aside, I've really enjoyed working with Tormach and getting to know them, both with the products but also the company, is that it's all about like the democratization of manufacturing. I don't care if you don't have a certain background or you're not a certain type of person, like, you could do it now. You know, there are people who I think have gone through traditional machining programs who think it's unkosher that someone could do this, but again, I don't really care. I usually tell people I'm not a machinist. I'm just a guy who happens to run machines, and I love it. I've enjoyed learning from a lot of those guys, Keith Fenner, Adam, etc. I continue to learn. I mean, that's what it is. I love learning those guys clearly love sharing, and I've helped a couple of them out when I can on either CNC stuff or CAD or CAM stuff. I can't remember what the book was, but it's a guy who talks about the 10,000 hour rule, where you've got to do something for 10,000 hours. But like the Beatles play together for 10,000 hours, or guys that do certain things or whatever. And I'm pretty sure I put in some number close to that of machining. So you can kind of teach yourself anything if you've got that discipline. But yeah, and again, it goes back to being able to not just use the machines, but run a business with them. At the end of the day, I love the fact that Tormach's been part of my story, that we've had so much success with the machines, but just do it. And if that means you've got to build your own CNC, or you've got to find something to use or whatever, just do it. Talk less, do more. Now, again, when I think about it, how little information there was out there, how expensive, thousands of dollars for CAD or CAM, and just much more of a black hole about getting stuff out there. Now, man, you've got Fusion 360, which is free for home people, and you've got venues like Kickstarter and Facebook where you can push out products and knowledge, and you can learn everything you need to learn, or put everything on YouTube. It is a great, I think we all should be thankful, and it's an awesome time, awesome era to be in.